Hi, here we're going to show you how to make a simple graph of carbon dioxide concentration on the y-axis versus the year on the x-axis. We're following the example from our first lesson. In this cell, I'll put the title year, and in the next cell over, CO2 in parts per million, and I'll pick 1800, just type it in and then hit the enter button. 1960, enter. 1990, and 2010. And then for the carbon dioxide levels, I'll use the 280 parts per million value that is a good estimate for the 1800 pre-industrial times, but I'm going to make up the values for these other years, 320, 350, and 390. You'll want to read your graph a little more carefully to get the exact values. Now, what I'm going to do is make a graph of the carbon dioxide values on the y-axis versus the year on the x-axis. And to do that, I just select these two columns side by side, go up to Insert, and use the XY scatter plot. This is the graph that is most used by scientists. And there you have it. I'll get rid of the legend here because I only have one line, so that's really not needed. I'll click on it to select it, and then I'll hit the delete button. And then I can add the axes labels or titles by going to the layout, axes titles, primary will be year, and again I'll just hit enter. And for the vertical, I'll use a rotated value, and I'll put CO2 in parts per million. That looks pretty good. Now I could also make this a little bit fancier by right-clicking and formatting the plot area using a fill color and then changing it to the color of my choice. Maybe this is a nice color. But that's getting a little bit beyond the point. In the next video, we'll show you how to do one extra thing that you'll need to know. Oh, I might as well mention here, if I wanted to do some more formatting with like the fonts and things like that, I have to click on the Home tab, and then I can go bold and a bigger font and play around like that.